Here we have a new GoPro frame. Now, I do have quite a few of these little black frames you might have seen, but one of the differences here, this one does have a quick release. It's a little newer model called the frame, and it comes with a cap. Now, I'll put it on my GoPro. I don't think I have any visible flaws in my lens yet, but I do have some chips, so I'm gonna put this cap on it from now on. And when it falls off my tripod, because I just balance it, then this will finally offer some protection without covering up the mic. It's also a more open design, even more so than the other frame I have. So this should be a good unit. And guys, as I mentioned in a previous video, I did get a bass radio to try. Now I got a killer deal on this, $99 shipped. And they actually paid over 20 bucks to ship it, I found out, on Priority, because the price is there. So again, the point of this is not to get better sound quality, obviously. Don't say the obvious. I'm not looking for better sound quality. What I'm looking for is, I have no need for the nav that's there. The touchscreen is crappy and slow and lags compared to other touchscreens, I'll say, that I've used. And what I really like about this bass radio, which also is in the Forester, is you have tactile buttons that are instant. And if I was gonna go through my XM presets on my touchscreen, it's press it, wait a second to a second and a half, press it, wait a second, second and a half. And you have 4 seconds there wasted while you're waiting for the touchscreen to refresh every screen. Here you just go 1, 2, 3, bang, you're there. Preset 3, 2, 4. Everything is a half second delayed minimum on the touchscreen unit. So if this will even work when I plug it in, I think it'll work, but I don't know if everything will work. And if it'll work with the Harman Kardon. Now the Harman Kardon is not in the nav unit itself, so I think it would work. However, the car could be programmed to expect certain things from the head unit that aren't going to match up right. Of course, the Sirius satellite won't be activated unless they left it activated. And if I ended up really liking the radio, I'd of course change over my subscription. But I'm real interested in whether the Harman Kardon will still function and sound the proper volumes and quality with this unit, or if it's a whole different output from both units. I don't think it would be, because they really would, you'd think they'd make them very compatible, so you just swap them in. But a lot of times you do need a programming at the dealer if you're going to change this radio out. So I'm just interested to see if I can even get sound out of it. And as long as it sounds the same, I'm not looking for better, as long as it sounds the same with the HK functioning properly, there's a chance I might keep this in there. Also, everybody says, I mean, I even know from the wife, that the Bluetooth is pretty bad on this unit. I don't use that much Bluetooth. I can't remember the last time my phone rang in the car. I mean, it'd be nice to have, sure, but I rarely ever use it. And additionally, I haven't streamed music in the car in quite a while. I don't do that too often either. So if the Bluetooth did give me a few issues, it wouldn't be the end of the world. Of course, I definitely keep the nav unit. It has to go with the car whenever the car leaves this household someday. I know I've been looking at chargers a lot, a really sweet white charger I liked. Even the new Golf R's look killer, but it's not that time yet. I've been spending too much money on this car. I have stuff coming in the next 2 weeks for this car, just all kinds of stuff on the way. So it isn't time to part yet, but I sure do like some of those new cars I'm looking at too for something different. It's just the more I do to this car, the harder it's going to be to change it out for something else, because the car is really personalized and I've put a lot of time and effort into it, 2 years of my life into making it this far, and it's pretty dang far. It's pretty dang nice. I have another mod that I've tried a few times, which is coming in again. You could guess on that, because there's probably been at least 10 mods that I've tried a few times. some other things that might be coming from other vendors, a lot of stuff going on. So first thing I want to do is see if this head unit fits. Let's get to the point. So let's get started. Guys, I suddenly had a bad feeling about this as far as bezel itself. I can't even imagine that this would have a different size bezel for each radio, but it could. So let me measure before I waste time with all this work. 8 inches, we're looking at the nav, 8 inches by 4, exactly, 8 by 4. I somehow thought the other one could be bigger, but it could just be an optical illusion, or else I can't even try this. Oh, good, good. 8 inches by 4. Okay, it's an illusion because of the offset of the screen. It made it look like the nav is a much smaller radio, but I think it is not. So I will continue and try and fit this. So this is just like the hood job I did. I'm gonna do something like this. Try and pry in right here. I probably need a smaller pry. My hands are a bit wet also. In there. Just like that. Now it does take a little strength. I like to use my fingers rather than plastic or screwdrivers because, I mean, just less chance of you really screwing up and pulling something out. Now it is hung here with a lot of harnesses. I'll try and get these harnesses off because it would just be so much easier to do it right and get this out of the way instead of trying to work around it. It'll just be a mess. So I'll do that off camera, try and disconnect all the wires which are connecting this climate unit pretty much, and even some wires on top here too. All right, guys, so that is only 3 plugs that you have to do. Let me get you, let's see, are these lights on? Yeah, they are on, can't show you too much. There you go, 3 plugs, 2 up here and 1 here. That's it, that's all you have. 1 plug and 2 here. And interesting, another little harness there for something that goes on a different car. But everything I have here is set up normally. Okay, so this is out of the way. Let me just move this to a very soft place. And then I'm going to start removing some of these screws to just slide the head unit out. It should really not be too hard a task. I don't really like that near my big heavy mufflers. Let me move that aside a little bit. Right there. It's probably an expensive ass piece if you crack it. So I got out the 2 screws here, the 4 screws along the bottom, and then this is like a bracket piece that goes over those radio screws. See that? So you have to do all 4, and I'll just keep everything in there and those little screws in there too. Now the head unit is loose. Get you a decent angle on that. Let's see what we got here. Okay. It's a little bit tight. Let's see. I'm probably have to work a little bit back here and find out. Let me tuck some of these into the AC and see. There's some wires that might need to be disconnected as you're taking it out, which could be really tricky. I'm gonna need some time on this. So the first thing I took off was this little ground strap, which goes right underneath on that little clip right there. That's the first thing I was gonna take off. Because I found the trick to getting it out. So see that little gray wire? It had tape around it, snaked together there. And once you remove that tape, you now have access to pull the whole radio out all the way. So that tape would be a factory install from the factory where they didn't need to do it this way, because you couldn't tape it once it's in. You could maybe, but it's a lot trickier. So you probably don't need to tape it back. And if you can get to it, sure, go ahead. But that's how I'll be able to pull this out a little bit more and try and see what else is connected to it. You might as well go ahead and throw some protection on here, just in case you get a little contact there on the edges. A little extra insurance there, just for backup. And you can always clean this off with your nice cleaner later if there's any residue left on your dash. Damn, this thing has a lot of connectors on it. Okay, well, no, it just, not a lot. A lot more than that other radio is going to have. So let's just go through them here before I disconnect anything, for my own sanity. So you got two connectors there. That's a better light. Two connectors at the bottom there, and a gray one, a black one with a little, there's the light is better, with a little black tape on it into this gray piece right there. There it is. And that's on this side, the passenger side. Then on the driver's side, you have a bunch of crap. You have two greens over on the edge. See those two? And let's see how I can differentiate. Okay, the top green has foam right at the near the connector. The bottom green does not, in case I get those mixed up. The bottom green has a blue base. The top green has a gray base. Then you have one wire into this white connector up top here. I get the lights just right. One wire only in there. That's weird. And then finally, you have a vertical and a horizontal white down there too. I have a feeling this new radio just isn't going to work that well, considering it only has like half of these connections. But let's go ahead and just try it, man. All right. None of the connectors were hard to get out or anything. Let's have a nice solid look here so everybody has a reference for the rest of their lives on this head unit. We'll do a comparison also. So if I hold it like this, let me figure out where I was. Okay, the greens, your top green went in this gray connector here. And I'm sure one of these is nav, maybe one of these is Sirius, who knows. Your bottom green here underneath went to your blue, your vertical, and your horizontal went here, and you had one wire horizontal which went in the top, and then you had your two main harnesses here and here, and finally this gray one that's getting a little lost, falling a little bit back there. Let me get that gray one out up to the top. There it is. It springs back a little bit. And your gray one was into this gray connector here. So on this unit here, these two were not used, and everything else was used. Man, this is very different. I sure hope nothing blows on this. So anyway, you have your... That might even be... I don't know, that could be the nav. I don't know enough about these antennas to tell you which is which. But see here, you're gonna have, you know what? This is not gonna work at all. I've just confirmed it. I've fully confirmed it. It's not gonna work. I'm putting it all back together. Your main harness is a totally different key pattern for these radios, which means they do use a different radio harness set for this whole thing. So it took getting to this point to find out that fact, that I cannot just plug in this unit at all. No big deal. I mean, it was cheap, as I said. It was just something to play with. But yeah, I'm glad it's keyed so I don't blow nothing up. Definitely way, way too different. And that connector there is not going to plug into this hole over here. No way in hell. So lesson learned. Good research, stuff like that. And I'm just going to put the original back in and this was a good learning experience to kind of see how it all works. But I see now the nav harness is far more complicated than the base radio stuff, and it's just not something I want to mess with and end up blowing something. It was just a little test for fun. So I suppose, not that anybody needs this, it's so cherry I'd almost put it on my wall, make it an ornament. But if someone does need it at some point, I want a Q-tip off the edge of that CD shelf right there and get it really cherry. I do have this really cherry radio, probably not worth much of anything. It's a 2014, I believe. And it is nice though, no scratches or nothing if you got one that's bunged up a little bit. But the key is you'd need to see, you'd have to really pull yours out and make sure it has the exact same connectors before you'd even think about purchasing anything like that. This also has an extra harness here. I don't know what that would be for. Right there. Maybe it plugs into a little different unit. Okay, that's it. Test abandoned. I'll see you guys later.